Hello everyone, welcome to Discrete Mathematical Structure. In previous session, I have discussed the truth value of a quantified statement, logical equivalence, rules of inference, and the negation of a quantified statement. In this session, I will discuss about logical implication in quantifiers. Okay, let's get started. Logical implication in quantifiers is mainly used to check the validity of an argument. To check whether the given argument is valid or invalid, we need to use the logical implication. A quantifier said to be logically imply a quantified statement Q if Q is true whenever P is true. Then we can write it as P implies Q. Whenever P is true, Q must be true. Then only we can say that P implies Q. Given a set of quantifier statement P1, P2 and so on, Pn and Q. So we have n quantifier statement and we have one more Q, that is the conclusion of the argument. So P1, P2, P3 are call it as a premises of the argument. Okay. The conjunction of all these n quantified statement or premises P1 and P2 and P3 and so on and Pn imply Q is a valid argument if Q is true whenever P1, P2, P3 and so on Pn is true. So this Q is true, the conclusion of the argument is true whenever all these statements are true, all these quantified statements are true, then only the Q is true. If Q is true, then it is a valid argument. If Q is false, then it is an invalid argument. Okay, then we can write it as conjunction of n quantified statement P1 and P2 and P3 and Pn imply Q. So whenever all these quantified statements are true, then Q must be true for valid argument. For invalid, it is false. Okay, we have studied rules of inference and laws of logic in the previous session. The same concepts you are applying here also to check the validity of an argument in quantifiers. Okay, let's solve one problem. Prove that the following argument is valid. All men are mortal. Sachin is a man. Therefore, Sachin is mortal. Okay. For all, so now here we need to consider the universe is set of all men. Set of all men will be the universe, and here we can take x is a mortal, is nothing but p of x. Then the x is value is given here, Sachin. Sachin is a man. Okay. Now we can write it as let s denote the set of all men. This is the universe for the given argument. Okay, P of x represent x is mortal and A represent Sachin. So Sachin is a man. It belongs to S. Okay, then the given argument we can write it as for all x belongs to S, P of x. Here x represents the man, so all men belongs to the universe S, and P of x is nothing but x is mortal, and here the name of the man is given, that is Sachin. So that is, you can write it as A belongs to S. So S denotes the set of all men, so Sachin is belongs to this set. Okay, therefore we can write it as Sachin is a mortal. How we can write? Now here x is mortal, so here the value of x is given, that is Sachin. Sachin is mortal, so you can write it as therefore P of A. Since the statement for all x belongs to S, P of x is true, and A belongs to S is also true, It follows the rule of universal specification, that is P of A is true. So in rule of universal specification, if for all x belongs to x, P of x is true, then if A belongs to S, then we can write it as a P of A is true in universal specification. Therefore, the given argument is valid. Okay, the next problem is, prove that the following argument is valid. For all x, P of x, conditional Q of x. For all x, Q of x, conditional Q of R of x. Therefore, for all x, P of x, conditional R of x. If I take first one, for all x, P of x, conditional Q of x, and second one, for all x, Q of x, conditional R of x. Okay. Now we can write it as, if we apply rule of syllogism, we can write the given statement as, for all x, in rule of syllogism, P conditional Q, Q conditional R, then you can write it as P conditional R. Similarly, we need to write here P of X conditional R of X. Therefore, the given argument is valid in the view of rule of syllogism. Next, the third problem is, find whether the following argument is valid. If a triangle has two equal sides, then it is isosceles. If a triangle is isosceles, then it has two equal angles. A certain angle ABC does not have two equal angles. We have three statements here. The conclusion will be, the triangle ABC does not have two equal sides. Okay. The first statement is a conditional statement. If and then is used. If and then. And here we need to consider the universe is set of all triangles. S represents the set of all triangles. Now here the first statement is a, I can take it as x has two equal sides. Next I can take next quantified statement, I can take it as x is isosceles. Next one more statement, we have x has two equal angles. So we have three statements here. One is two equal sides, one is isosceles, and two equal angles. And here the name of the triangle is given here, triangle ABC. Okay, now we can write it as, let the universe be the set of all triangles. Now P of x, we can write it as x has two equal sides. X has two equal sides, and Q of x you can write it as x is isosceles, and R of x you can write it as x has two equal angles. Now A represents a triangle ABC. Now value of x is given, that is A. A is nothing but triangle ABC. Now we can write the given statement as, if a triangle has two equal sides, that is here the quantifier is not mentioned, then you have to take for all x. For all x, the triangle has two equal sides, that is P of x has two equal sides, right? So you have to write P of x, then conditional, it is isosceles, that is Q of x represents the isosceles. Next one, for a triangle, for all x, triangle is isosceles, so Q of x represents the third one. A certain triangle ABC does not have two equal angles. Now here R of x represents x has two equal angles. Now if we take negation of this one, x does not have two equal angles. Next here we need to take negation of R of A, the triangle ABC. Therefore, the triangle ABC does not have two equal sides. Now here, P of x represents x has two equal sides. Now if I take triangle ABC, x is A, then you can write it as P of the triangle ABC does not have two equal sides. That is, we need to take negation of the P of B. So now we need to prove this one. The quantified statement is valid only when negation P of A is true. Okay. In the given argument, write it as, for all x, P of x conditional Q of x. For all x, Q of x conditional R of x, negation of R of A, therefore negation of P of A. We know that the rule of syllogism, P of x conditional Q of x conditional R of x is nothing but P of x conditional R of x. You can write these two statements as P of x conditional R of x for all x by rule of syllogism. Okay, next one we have negation of R of A. Next, we need to take x is nothing but A. We need to replace x by A in the quantified statement P of x conditional R of x. If you replace x by A, you will get P of A conditional R of A. I can write these two statements as and negation of R of A. Okay. In the view of Modus-Tollens rule, we can write it as negation of P of A. In the view of Modus-Tollens rule, we can write this given statement as negation P of A. So Modus-Tollens rule is nothing but P conditional Q, negation Q, therefore negation P. So we can write the given statement in the view of Modus-Tollens rule, we can write it as negation of P of A. Therefore, we got the value negation P of A after simplifying the given quantified statement. Therefore, the given argument is valid. So, this is a valid argument. Thank you. Happy learning.